Praise Jesus, child of God. Shalom, shalom. My name is Charlie G. This is Slicer Today. Thank you very much for tuning in for Slicer Today. I know and I do believe that each and every one of us are going to be blessed by our Slicer Today. And yesterday, I attended my friend's birthday. Yeah, she's called Diane. And so for me, the thing about birthdays is usually just a day for one to get to know him or herself, whatever he has done from this angle. In that having friends come to celebrate your birthday, and each and every one of them are like telling you of how you bring a blessing to them, of how you met, of how life has been when you were there. In that showing the time of just reflecting upon your life for you to just know that you've done a lot in that year ever since they got to know you, ever since you got to know them, in that a lot has happened. And so I'd like to encourage each and every one of us during your birthday. It's usually good for one to receive the wishes, usually good for one to tell everyone else that it's my birthday, and so that they can like speak words of blessing to you, they can encourage you, they can admonish you. And so I hope that you have gotten about to know about it. In the Bible, we read about two birthdays. One of them was the birthday of Pharaoh. The birthday of Pharaoh in the story of Genesis. In that we all know the story of Joseph in prison, and then when it was the king's birthday, he had the two servants. He had his two officials who were serving him thrown in the kitchen. Thrown in the cell. The cupbearer, and the baker. He had them thrown into the cell, and then after an year later on, Joseph interpreted a dream. Then he was called to the courts of Pharaoh, and then Pharaoh had a disturbing dream. He didn't know what it meant. It was during his birthday, and so the first time that it was mentioned in the story of Pharaoh was when he, to the cupbearer, he was given back the position that he was having, but the baker, he was hung. It was during his birthday, and then after 3 years, yes, and then it usually says after 3 years. That's when Joseph got to see Joseph. And so we are seeing that during his birthday, in that there was one who was given back the job that he was having. So that is the same thing to each and every one of us during a birthday. Maybe there could be someone who wronged you. Maybe there's someone who you also threw in the cell. That's like putting someone in a particular place. And so during your birthday, just reestablishing your friendship, your relationship that you had with them. Usually very good. And also the other one is the birthday of Herod, and then Herod was having his birthday. He had invited his friend for his birthday, and then the daughter of Pharaoh, in that Herod's brother, but it was sweet, I don't know. Yeah, and so he got to like she danced, and then she asked for the head of John the Baptist, because the mother told her to request for the head of John the Baptist. So those are the two times, two the instances that we read about birthday in the Bible. And we see in that people are being invited, people are there in the celebration, people are in that there's one head being lifted up, another head's being lifted off. And so my prayer, my heart is that during our friend's birthday, may our heads be lifted up and not be cut off, So let us pray. Almighty and Heavenly Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I'm grateful yet another opportunity, another privilege you've given unto me to share a word. And dearly Father, let your word come with light. Let the entrance of your word bring light and understanding to the simple God. And dearly Father, I know in the view that each and every one of us are going to be blessed by your word, O God. Let your word be seen in our hearts and bear fruits in our lives. And this is a prayer of faith that I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen, amen, amen. This is my first sharing in this new week that we are in. And I know and I do believe that each and every one of us are going to be blessed. Today I'm going to be fun sharing about honoring God in the honoring God in the life, that we should live a life of being truthful. We should live a life of being truthful and not lying. Because the devil is the father of all lies, and he has been lying from the very beginning. And so it's a thing for each and every one of us. We find living a life of being truthful, living a life of telling the truth. In the Bible says that if you want to see better days, and that we shall read of it in the book of Peter, if I'm not wrong. First Peter 3:10, it says what? In the book of First Peter chapter 3 verse 10. For whoever would love life and see good things must keep his tongue from evil and their lips for deceitful speech. They must turn from evil and do good. They must seek peace and pursue it. For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are attentive to their prayer. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil. Whoever would love life and see better days. And so I hope that you are understanding what the word of the Lord is saying. Whoever would love life and see good days. If you and I would like to see good days, in that, for me, I do believe that we are living in the better day. For me, as long as Jesus Christ is alive, we are living in the better days. We are living in the good days. We are living in the better days. And let none of you ever before living a life of saying that better are the good days. Because in the book of Proverbs say that a fool will say that gone are the good days. A fool will say gone are the good days. But for someone who is wise, in that he or she will say that these are the better days. And so for each and every one of us, let us believe that we are living in the better days. For the path of the righteous man keeps on getting better and brighter as the perfect days keeps on dawning. In that, as long as our Redeemer lives, we live to see tomorrow. In that, let none of us ever live worrying about tomorrow, because let tomorrow worry about itself. But its own sufficiency lies in today. And that is for each and every one of us to live a life of always making the best out of each and every day that the Lord grant unto us. In the Bible says that for this day the Lord has made, so that we shall rejoice and be glad in you. And so these are the days for you and I. In that, if your tomorrow is better than your today, then there's something wrong. If your tomorrow is better than today, then there's something wrong. For each and every one of us, in that we should believe that we are living in the better days. We are living in the better days. A fool will say that gone are the past day. A wise man will say that these are the better days. These are the better days. Whoever would love life and see good days must keep his tongue from evil. So for each and every one of us, keeping our tongue from evil is all about us living a life of taming our tongue. In the book of James, the person who shall be able to tame their tongue, in that they're able to control their body. Anyone who is able to control their tongue, they're able to control their body. And then he gives an example of a horse having the bait, and whenever it has the bite, I'm ain't sure about the pronunciation, but it's usually the thing that a horse usually has in its mouth, so that the rider can always tell it go right, go left, go straight forward, and also halt, stop. So for each and every one of us, that's the same thing about each and every one of us. In that, when we live a life of being able to tame our tongue, when we live a life of taming our tongue, then we shall live a life in straightforwardness. Then we shall live a life of having our yes being a yes and a no being a no. Whoever would love life and see good days must keep his tongue from evil. And so it's a thing for each and every one of us. Let your yes be a yes and let your no be a no. Let your yes be a yes and let your no be a no. And that, don't be someone who is double-minded. Don't be someone who today you're saying yes and the other minute you're going, if you have fun saying no. And that's the thing about honoring God. That's the thing about honoring God. It's a thing for each and every one of us, in that I myself I strive for the very most, in that to live a life of being truthful. I strive very much to live a life of always saying the truth, no matter how painful shall be, in that always being there to say the truth, always being there to say the truth, because the truth will always set us free. The more you continue on entangling yourself, the more you continue on building walls for yourself, and before you know it, it shall be locked in. Whoever would love life and see good days must keep his tongue from evil and their lips from deceitful speech. They must turn from evil and do good. You see, that's the thing about repenting. Repenting comes from repent. In that, repent is usually like a pentagon house. And so repent is usually a thing like God is telling you, come back higher. In that, have your minds on the things above. Yesterday night I was sharing from the book of Genesis. From the book of Genesis said that man's heart is usually deceitful from when they are youth. Man's heart is usually deceitful from when they are they are youthful, and so and then it reminded me of reminded me of the way Forrest said that fix your mind on the things above, fix your mind on the things above, set your heart on the things above. And so that's a call for each and every one of us. You see, as in our heart is usually deceitful in nature, and that's why we are encouraged by Paul in that we should set our affection on the things above, we set our minds on the things above, set our hearts on the things above, and so that we can be found living a life, so that we can be found living a life in righteousness. They must stand from evil and do good, and let none of us ever get weary of doing good, for in due time we shall always reap. Let none of us ever get weary of doing good, for in due time we shall reap. They must seek peace and pursue it. In that, peace is really important. And so for this peace, we should seek it. And our Lord Jesus Christ is the peace of peace. And then also living a life of having his peace rule our heart and mind. In peace and quietness is our salvation. There's a verse in the book of Isaiah talks about in rest is our salvation. I've forgotten of the verse. Let me see if I can get it. Yeah, in peace is a salvation. Let's just continue. For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous. And his ears are attentive to their prayer. And so if you know that you're righteous, then you should pray. In that the eyes of the Lord are upon you, and his ears is attentive to your prayers. And so the Lord will like to hear us praying. The Lord will like to hear us calling unto his name. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil. And so each and every one of us living a life that honors God, in that I hope and I do believe that you picked a point or two in that of how we can live a life of honoring the Lord, in that the theme of our mouth is that light in our dwelling. And so in our dwelling, always living a life of honoring the Lord. And today I would like us to look at the story of in the book of Joshua chapter 7, we read about Achan's sin. And this is a thing that in the book of Joshua chapter 7, we read about Achan's sin. And so, but the Israelite were unfaithful in regard to the devoted thing. Achan, son of Carmi, the son of Zimi, the son of Zerah, of the tribe of Judah, took some of them. So the Lord's anger burned against Israel. Now Joshua sent men from Jericho to Ai, which is near Beth Aven, to the east of Bethel, and told them, go up and spy out the region. So the men went up and spied at Ai. They returned to Joshua. They said, Not all the army will have to go up against Ai. Send 2,000 or 3,000 men to take it, and do not weary the whole army, for only a few people live there. So about 3,000 went up, but they were routed by the men of Ai, who killed about 36 of them. They chased the Israelites from the city gate as far as the stone quarries and struck them down on the slope. At this, the hearts of the people melted in fear and became like water. Then Joshua tore his clothes and fell face down to the ground, because the ark of the Lord remaining there till evening. The elders of Israel did the same and sprinkled dust on their heads. And Joshua said, alas, sovereign Lord, why did you ever bring these people across the Jordan to deliver us into the hands of the Amorites to destroy us? If only we had been content to stay on the other side of Jordan. Pardon your servant, Lord, what can I say? Now that Israel has been routed by their enemies, the Canaanites and other people of the country will hear about this, and they will surround us and wipe out our name from the earth. What then will you do for your own great name? The Lord said to Joshua, stand up. What are you doing down on your face? Israel has sinned. They have violated my covenant, which I commanded them to keep. They have taken some of the devoted things. They have stolen. They have lied. And so this is the thing that I would like each and every one of us in that getting to live a life of honoring God, is getting to live a life of being truthful, keeping His commandment. In the letter now we found being people who shall lie. Because here as you read, as we are continuing on reading in the story of Achan, in the book of Joshua chapter 7, in that they went against the enemy eye, but they were not able to fight against them. They're not able to fight against them because of that, because they are taking devoted things, they are stolen, they are lied, they have put them with their own possession. That's why the Israelites cannot stand against their enemy. You see, when people live a life of lies, you'll fail to stand against your enemy. When you live your life a life of lies, in that you shall always be shaking. When people come, evaluating, people come and investigating, people come to find out how you have been doing your businesses, how you have been balancing your scale, in that you shall always be shaking because of the lies. That's why the Israelites cannot stand against the enemy. They turn their backs and run because they have made liable to destruction. I will not be with you anymore unless you destroy whoever among you is devoted to destruction. Go consecrate the people, tell them, consecrate yourself in preparation for tomorrow. For this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, said. There are devoted things among you, Israel. You cannot stand against your enemy until you remove them. And so in my dwelling, and so in our dwelling, and so in our dwelling, we should be found living a life of being truthful. In our dwelling, each and everything that we acquire, let us be found acquiring it the right way. Because when we live a life of not acquiring things the right way, when we live a life of stealing, of corrupting, of lying, and then the destruction shall come unto us. And so it's a thing for each and every one of us. And once you are having those things in your dwelling, in that, things shall be found going haywire in your life. This shall be found going south in your life, and that's not the will of God. The will of God for each and every one of us is for each and every one of us to live a life of going heavenward, for each and every one of us to live a life of going upward. That's God's will for each and every one of us. And so in verse 14 says that in the morning present yourself tribe by tribe, and the tribe the Lord chooses shall come forward, clan by clan, the clan that the Lord chooses shall come forward, family by family, the family that God chooses shall come forward. Man by man, whoever is caught by the devoted thing shall be destroyed by fire, along with all the things belongs to him. He has violated the covenant of the Lord and has done an outrageous thing in Israel. Early the next morning, Joshua and the Israelites came forward by tribes, and Judah was chosen. The clans of Judah came forward, and the Zarephites were chosen. He had the clan of Zarephites come forward by family. Zerim was chosen. Joshua had his family come forward, man by man. Achan, son of Carmi, the son of Rim, the son of Zerah, of the tribe of Judah, were chosen. Then Joshua said to Achan, "My son, give glory to God, the God of Israel, and honor him." And so living a life of honoring God is living a life of truthfulness. It's all about each and every one of us living a life of truthfulness. In that you rather have God on your side. And so, tell me what you have done and do not hide from me. Achan replied, "It's true, I have sinned against the Lord, the God of Israel. This is what I have done. When I saw the plunder of beautiful robes, in that we are usually living a life constantly fighting against the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. And that we usually live a life of always being up against this thing, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. And so here we are seeing Achan. Achan was caused by the lust of the eyes. In that, when I saw the plunder of beautiful robe from Babylon, 200 shekel of silver and the bar of gold weighing 50 shekel, I coveted them and took them. They are hidden in the ground inside my tent, in my dwelling, let none of us be found hiding anything in our dwelling. Because when we hide anything in our dwelling, then it shall cost us our life, in that we shall not live a good life. He who loves life and you like to see good days, he who loves life and you like to see good days. That's what you have read. And so verse 22, so Joshua sent messengers, and they ran to the tent, and there it was hidden in the tent with the silvers underneath. They took the things for the tent, brought them to Joshua, and the Israelites spread them out before the Lord. Then Joshua, together with the Israelites, took Achan, son of Zerah, the silver, the robe, the gold bar, his sons and daughters, his cattle, donkey, sheep, his tent, and all that he had, You see, as in Achana defiled everything. Achana defiled everything because of what he had taken, because of what he had taken. And so it's a call to each and every one of us, in that you rather start it from, you rather start again, you rather start afresh with God. In that there's a friend of mine, he's called John. There's a friend of mine, he's called John, in that he used to, there's a while back, in that he used to have things from the kingdom of darkness, but one time round, in that he got to be born again, God got to convict him, in that to sell everything, to let go of everything, and to start afresh, and to have nothing of the kingdom of darkness, and to have nothing of the kingdom of darkness. That's also a thing for each and every one of us, in that we ought to live a life of having nothing of the kingdom of darkness. We ought to live a life of having everything that the Lord has given unto us. For every good gift and every perfect gift comes down from the Father of life, who never changes, so cause the darkness by turning around, in that the blessings of the Lord has no sorrow. It's a thing about each and every one of us living a life of allowing the Lord to satisfy all our desires. And before living a life of having the Lord satisfy all our desires. Then all the Israelites stoned him, and after they had stoned the rest, they burnt them. Over Achan, they heaped up a large pile of rocks, which remains to this day. The Lord turned from his fierce anger, therefore the place had been called the Valley of Ocha ever since. The Valley of Ocha ever since. And so it's my prayer, my heart is that we are going to know about living a life of honoring God. Is all about living a life of being truthful, and living a life of keeping his commandment, living a life of obeying, of trusting and obeying him, living a life of having nothing of the devil, of having nothing of the enemy. In the whatever the Lord shall give unto you, in that receive it with thanksgiving. Whatever the Lord shall give unto you, I receive it with thanksgiving. In that don't live a life of giving in to the lust of the eyes, lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. Let each and every one of us be found living a life of being content with that which the Lord has entrusted unto us. And that same thing in the Garden of Eden. In the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve were allowed to eat from any tree in the garden, but in the tree that was in the middle of the garden, they were told not to eat anything from it, for the trees which are in the middle of the garden, they were told not to eat from him. That is the same to each and every one of us, in that God has given us a lot. God has given us too much. God loves us. God loves us too much. God loves us too much. And so it's a thing for each and every one of us to live a life that pleases the Lord, to live a life that honors the Lord, to live a life that shall bring glory and honor unto God. Let us not be found being used of the enemy. Yeah, so that's it for today. Shalom, shalom. Till next time, may the Lord bless you. Thank you. Hi, I hope that you liked our slice of today, as long as it's today. According to the book of Hebrews chapter 3 verse 13, I welcome you to subscribe to our YouTube channel A Slice of Today, and also hit the notification bell. I'd also like you to like and follow our Facebook fan page A Slice of Today. You have to follow us on Twitter A Slice of Today. You have to follow us on Telegram A Slice of Today. Get to follow us on Instagram @slice_of_today. Get to download Slice of Today application from Play Store, The Slice of Today. Get to also join us on WordPress at The Slice of the Day blog, The Slice of the Day blog. And also, if you'd like me to add you to my WhatsApp Slice of Today group, get to text me on 0708884323. And I know, and I do believe with the various social media handle that you are having, you're gonna be blessed by all the content, by all the things that we get to share. So be blessed. As long as it's today, we hear from the Lord.